differ on the meaning. No excuse for them. The third misconception, compiling the Quran. They say, you have books today, you have, Quran. Why did you put the Quran in a mushaf? Huh? The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do it. Here you're doing bid'ah, because this is part of the deen. Huh? It sounds funny, huh? No. Guess what? Hadith is in Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا تكتبوا عني ومن كتب عني غير القرآن فليمحه. Do not write down what I say. And whosoever writes down anything other than the Quran, then let him erase it. What does that mean? They were writing the Quran. You read in Bukhari. In Bukhari, read the chapter dealing with the compilation. And you will see, in the clearest words, the Sahaba used to write down the Quran on leaves, on anything, rocks, anything that they were able to write on, they would write the Quran on these things. At the time of the Messenger of Allah, they used to write the Quran. Now he said, if I said something from my statement, erase it. Don't write it. But the Quran, keep it. So the Quran first was being written at the time of the Messenger of Allah. It's not an innovation. Writing it in a book is not an innovation. Second, it's a fulfillment of Allah's promise. Inna alayna jama'ahu wa Qur'ana. Upon us is collecting it and giving you the ability to recite it. Allah promised that this Quran will be collected. How could that be? It's in the book. Because when the people were, the Sahaba started dying in the battles, the Huffaz, the Qur'an were dying, then it was necessary that it would be compiled in a book. And Allah called it what in the Qur'an? Kitab. Qur'an means recital, recitation, that which you recite. Kitab means book. Allah called it a book. What are they talking about? Thirdly, the Sahaba agreed. The Sahaba agreed. And the Prophet ﷺ said, لَا تَجْتَمِعُ أُمَّتِي عَلَى ضَلَالَ. My ummah will never agree upon misguidance. If the Sahaba agreed, then how are you going to say this is a bid'ah? How will you say this is a bid'ah? They say, okay, if any time the whole Muslim ummah agrees on something, then it becomes a sunnah, then all our innovations are sunnah. We say no. First, the Sahaba agreed, not the people today. Second, I challenge you to find any bid'ah which all the Muslims agree on. Never. And we are the biggest evidence. We are sitting here today rejecting all these innovations. And with me, and we being the followers of the scholars of sunnah, are a lot. Never did we love the bid'ah or agree to it. So the ummah never agreed upon bid'ah. No excuse for them. No excuse. Fourthly, it couldn't have been done at the time of the Messenger of Allah. It could not have been done. Because the Quran was being revealed still, and some ayat were abrogating others, and the Quran was not yet complete. Once it was complete and he died, alayhi salatu wasalam, now you can put it in a book. Otherwise, they were writing it down. No excuse for them either. Alhamdulillah. Fourth, they say cars, airplanes, schools, blah, blah, blah. Say, ya akhi, these are from the dunya, not the deen. The Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, did not come to teach us how to be accountants, how to be teachers in school, how to be, workers. He did not come to teach us labor work, professions, inventing things. He didn't. He came to teach us what? The deen. Cars, schools, whatever. These are all part of the dunya, part of the dunya. Some of them may be categorized under the deen when they serve an Islamic objective, which the ulama call it al-masalih al-mursala, meaning things which benefit the Muslims that hasn't had a particular ruling concerning them. Wal-wasail hukmu hukmu al-maqasid, that means have the ruling of the objective. Meaning, if wearing atr, wearing tib, is it a sunnah to do it on Yawm al-Jumu'ah? If you don't have any, it becomes a sunnah for you to buy some in order to apply the sunnah of putting on some. So these are things that lead to something Islamic. They're not acts of worship in and of themselves. They're not acts of worship in and of themselves. And the last evidence we can use to refute them is the famous hadith when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw some of the Sahaba using a particular way in growing palm trees and taking care of them, and he advised them. Then when they took his advice, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it did not produce as many fruits Then he told them, O Messenger of Allah, you told us and we acted. He said, أنتم أعلموا بأمور دنياكم. You know best concerning the affairs of your dunya. That's an evidence that concerning the dunya, he had nothing to do with it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This was a matter of the deen. How do you get extra dates in a palm tree? It's from the deen or the dunya? It's from the deen, it's business. And he tried to advise him according to his nasiha alayhi salatu wasalam, the dunya, it didn't produce as many fruits. So they told him, O Messenger of Allah, this is what we have. He said, you know your dunya better than myself? SubhanAllah. So then it means the deen and the dunya are not the same.